couple days ago, some message somewhere said that I was supposed to do something. Didn't think about it, didn't realize until we were sitting there, I thought, oh yeah, I should have called and said I'd be here. This is such a cool place.
It is.
Amen.
It's fun to go to a church where you want to invite people because it's such a good user-friendly place, and God actually shows up most of the time too. I've been going through a struggle the last few days. I'll leave out a lot of details because I'm not supposed to do the sermon that much. But struggle with the idea of comparing my insides to somebody else's outsides. And we do that really easily when we think our lives are toast. I won't use the normal language in here to describe what we often think of our lives as being. But I struggle with that a lot, comparing myself. I have two brothers that are fabulously successful. One of them makes $1 million a day. He'll make more before lunch than most of us will make in two lifetimes. And so it's easy to compare myself to his pressurized helicopter and all that stuff. So I struggle with, am I significant or am I successful? We all have metrics for success, but am I significant? And in here we get to learn maybe there's a different metric on how to do that. Most famous sermon in the world says you might want to use a different measuring stick. The least shall be the most, the first, the last shall be first, the meat shall inherit the earth, and kind of goes on and on. That's a Matthew book, that's a different book. But today's book makes really clear it's a different metric. In Mark, in the 38th verse of the 12th chapter, we get to hear about a different metric that maybe we ought to look at a different way of considering our own significance. Because we tend to be puffed up and do all kinds of things. As he taught, Jesus said, watch out for the teachers of the law, the guys that carry the metrics. They like to walk around in flowing robes and be greeted with respect in the marketplaces, wearing Hart's chaffer and Mark's suits, and have the most important seats in the synagogues and the places of honor and banquets. But it says in another place in the same book, they can demote you, move you down the table, and in that culture, that was not cool. They devour widows' houses and for a show make lengthy prayers. These men will be punished most severely, and I don't want to know what that's about. Jesus sat down opposite the place where the offerings were put and watched the crowd putting their money into the temple treasury. Many rich people threw in large amounts, but a poor widow came and put in two very small copper coins, worth only a few cents. Calling his disciples to him, Jesus said, truly I tell you, this poor widow has put more into the treasury than all the others. They all gave out of their wealth, but she, out of her poverty, put in everything, all she had to live on. Seems like that's the word of the Lord for the people of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
That says that she had the trust thing going on. She had the faith thing going on. And it's scary when your money goes away, because in our culture, we learn to put our trust in the Wells Fargo Investment Bank. And I had a taste of that this week, but that doesn't hold up so well. So I'm going to quit because I don't think I'm supposed to do this, right?
Yeah.